After a little pause, to give the interest opportunity to gather and grow, he went on.
"Very good. Let us suppose the case of a pair of tongs that falls upon a man's foot, causing a cruel hurt. Will you claim that the tongs are punishable for that? The question is answered. I see by your faces that you would call such a claim absurd. Now, why is it absurd? It is absurd because, there being no reasoning faculty, that is to say, no faculty of personal command, in a pair of tongs, personal responsibility for the acts of the tongs is wholly absent from the tongs, and therefore, responsibility being absent, punishment cannot ensue. Am I right?"
A hearty burst of applause was his answer.
"Now then, we arrive at a man's stomach. Consider how exactly, how marvelously indeed, its situation corresponds to that of a pair of tongs. Listen, and take careful note, I beg you. Can a man's stomach plan a murder? No. Can it plan a theft? No. Can it plan an incendiary fire? No. Now answer me, can a pair of tongs?"
There were admiring shouts of,
"No!" and, "The cases are just exact!" and, "Don't he do it splendid!" "Now then, friends and neighbors, a stomach which cannot plan a crime cannot be a principle in the commission of it. That is plain, as you see. The matter is narrowed down by that much. We will narrow it further. Can a stomach of its own motion assist at a crime? The answer is no, because command is absent, the reasoning faculty is absent, volition is absent, as in the case of the tongs. We perceive now, do we not, that the stomach is totally irresponsible for crimes committed, either in whole or in part, by it?